Right?
I mean,
only like
it's not a very long series or anything. I think it was that one. That one. Okay.
How about you, Colleen?
Anytime Luffy gets emotional and choked up, that's difficult just in my, just for purely physical reasons, that's difficult for me to do. So, like, I can cry in a normal character that is more similar to my own range. I can cry to my heart's content and it sounds real. With Luffy, if I start actually crying, it completely disrupts how that voice is created and I'll end up sounding too feminine and the throat stuff kind of goes away and it makes it more difficult. So just from a purely physical standpoint, the emotional stuff is what is the most difficult.
So it's hard to actually get it out sounding as Luffy.
It's a weird sort of structure to this whole thing. A weird layer to add onto all of the acting is to constantly think about that voice and how it's created, and then also how it's hitting the ears of the audience in addition to how it's being created. So it adds a fun technical layer to it all.
That's so interesting.
It's complicated.
Yeah, it is very complicated.
I have another question here from Vinnie Murphy, who asks, who is your favorite villain in the series? And that's a very loose term, I feel like.
Yeah.
The term villain in the One Piece world.
Definitely.
And Mike, you can't pick Buggy. I'm just going to put that out there.
It's Foxy. We already said it, kind of.
Oh, that's true.
That is true.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That is
Foxy
true.
Mike, you always say Bon Clay, yeah.
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
Yeah, I guess it counts. Yeah, okay. It counts.
All right.
He's all so right. Funny, and Jonathan is so good at that character in the dub. I love him so, so. I could listen to him play that voice all day long. I think he's hilarious.
Yeah, both of those characters are so fun.
And Mike literally has listened to him play that character all day long, probably.
Yeah.
So.
Many days.
I got another one here from Fox Sinban. What character do you think has the most interesting backstory? That's a lot of characters to choose from. And, man, I have to say, in One Piece, this is probably the series that does the best for backstory.
I know. They do a great job in explaining exactly who this character is and why they feel the way they do.
So,
can I jump in?
Yes, go.
I'm jumping in first. I think a case could be made for either Nami or Robin, but I'm going to say Laboon, because I love Laboon so much. And that backstory just brings me to tears, so Laboon. And by extension, Brooke, I guess.
Yes. I recently learned about, you know, that little twist, and I literally, tears came back when I realized
terrible.
One of his friends is still alive.
If someone here watching happens to be new to One Piece, you've got a lot of emotional struggle to get through. But one thing that Funimation did, this isn't kind of an old video now, but there's a One Piece 101 series they did, and Nami's backstory. Funimation did a really good job of summarizing that backstory, and just in that short piece make me, like, every time I watch it, it's very difficult in a good way to watch.
Yeah,
so.
I'm just thinking about that part. I'm not gonna do it in case, you know, somebody hasn't.
Mike, is that your answer? I'm guessing. I'm gambling that's
Mike. Yeah, give it to us, Mike.
With the Laboon?
No, Nami.
What backstory?
Backstory?
Yeah. Nami, like, every Straw Hat's backstory is, it's almost like a contest to see which one makes me hurt my feelings the most. Nami's is rough, Brooks is rough, Chopper's is rough. There's so many that are rough. Yeah.
Oh, Chopper, no.
Man. So, I mean, that's what means it's a good show, right? When you actually care about all of that stuff, and it's so deep that it's difficult to watch, not because it's like a badly produced thing, but it's just like, it makes me feel too much.
Yes.
Yeah.
I
think that's what One Piece really excels at is, you know, we've seen a couple of episodes that just have a lot of comedy and a lot of fun in it. But when they throw you the curveball of something that is really that tugs at the heartstrings, I think that it pulls harder because of everything else that was around it. Like, I think that it hits harder.
Mm-hmm. You get your ups and
that's
downs.
That's what makes it. That's what makes it so hard to categorize One Piece. Some people would call it a comedy. Some people would call it an adventure. Some people would call it a drama in some ways. So, yeah, I love that about that.
It is all the things.
So many things. Mm-hmm. Oh, my gosh. So, another question here from the